great pyramids of Giza.
Isn't that something?
That is shit.
Good evening. I'm Tommy Gold, and you're watching You Big Fat Liar, the first TV program to give people who have been cheated on a proper TV revenge. This little honey, Alex, contacted the program about 2 weeks ago and said that she thought her boyfriend, George, who she's been going out with for 3 years, was cheating on her. Well, guess what, honey? He is, okay? And I got worse for you. He's in the restaurant behind us right now with the girl he's cheating on. You want some rough justice? You want to confront him? You want to tell him how you feel? You're going to make good TV? I'm Tommy Gold. Let's kick some ass. Where is he, honey? You George, huh? You George, I'm Tommy Gold from You Big Fat Liar. I brought your girlfriend here because you are cheating on her with this lowlife, huh? How do you think it feels, huh? My wife left me, huh? 3 years ago, I know how it feels. She trusted you with 3 years of her life, buddy. How do you think it feels?
It's time
people like you learned. Well, my wife left me. I cried for 6 months, buddy. You understand that? You know how it feels to have a woman leave you? What do you got to say? Come here, honey. What do you got to say to the woman's giving you 3 years of her life?
It's not him. It's not him.
Hmm?
It's not my boyfriend.
You George?
Yes.
You have a relationship with this woman?
No, with this woman. This is my girlfriend. A different from George.
Sorry, we made a mistake here. I'm sorry. I'm Tommy Gold. This is professionally embarrassing, man.
I'll bet you're wondering what's under my kilt. Huh? You'll be wondering what's under my kilt.
Oh,
hey. Huh? It's a potted geranium that Titchmarsh says you should keep in a dark, moist place. And I do.
Hoots!
My heart was broken. My heart was broken.
DCI Cheech, this is Inspector Chong. We're doing a police lineup in there, and we're one person short. Could we borrow you for 1 minute?
Yeah.
Just to do a lineup. Have you ever done a police lineup? Okay, you've seen it on the films, presumably.
I've had a whole cast from a theatre go out and do it.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
If you just come through, it'd be 1 minute. Thank you. If you just stand there, it'd be great. Thanks.
Afternoon, gentlemen. This is an official police ID parade, so I'd ask you all to put your numbers up by your chests. Look straight forward and please do not communicate with each other during the procedure. Thank you.
Okay, so which one did it?
Who's
that? Did the crime?
What crime?
The crime that we're investigating.
I don't know the crime we're investigating. I'm just walking down the road to the post office.
But I need someone to pick out a number.
For what reason?
One of these people is a suspected criminal, and we need to have a positive ID on them before we can take it further.
But you can't take it further. I haven't seen anybody to suspect anybody. I don't know anybody here.
You haven't seen any of these people involved in a crime?
No.
Not even number four?
That's pretty lead.
Well, I'm not meaning to lead, but it would help.
I haven't seen anybody. I don't know any of these people.
Okay, you've never seen number four?
No.
Doing any sort of crime? It would help very much if you could just say yes.
You cannot beat that view for anything in England, can you?
No.
That's it. Not like this Saatchi Gallery. You've been in the Saatchi Gallery?
No, I haven't.
Oh, you know, it's full of the modern art.
No, I don't like modern art anyway.
It's not art, frankly. It's just modern rubbish.
Yeah.
You know. Yeah. I went to Goldsmith College, where a lot of that lot trained, you know. Frankly, they're a talentless bunch. You know Damien Hirst, the guy he cut up a shark and cut up a sheep? And what is that? That's not art, is it? It's butchery. You know, he got a job in my uncle's butcher down in Lowestoft, and that's where I think he got the idea, because he was cutting up animals all the time, and he just suddenly thought, I know, I'll put it in a case and exhibit it. I could have done that, but I didn't, you know, because it's not art. So he's a multi-millionaire now, it's not a big deal, you know. I'm still better than him art-wise, you know, and that's what matters. And that Tracy Emin, you know her bed there that she did, the unmade bed?
Oh, yeah.
I've been not making my bed all my life, frankly, you know, leaving stuff around. I bet you have, you're a little bit scruffy. You know, we should have thought about exhibiting it, shouldn't we? Anyway, she came round to mine and saw my bed was an absolute mess, it really was, when we were at college. And you could see the glint in her eye there, thinking, some money's been made there, you know. And of course, I didn't think of it.
Yeah.
And one of the coffee cups that's actually by the bed is mine. Now, if I could claim that, how much is that worth? 10 grand? The thing went for a million.
Yeah.
It's unbelievable.
I'm at the stage where everything I thought meant something seems so unappealing. I'm ready for the real thing, but nobody's selling, no, except you. Yours saying, open up your eyes and ears and let me in of your brilliant minds. You must be out of your brilliant minds.
Is this your manor, squire?
What do you mean?
Do you run this manor?
No.
Alright, okay. I'm from England.
Mm-hmm.
Old Kent Road, you been there?
No.
You ever met any of my contacts over here? I got a couple of friends who moved over here downtown. They're like involved in the scene.
Mm-hmm.
You ever heard of Dirty Din?
No, I don't believe I have.
No? Sharon Watts?
No.
Michelle?
No.
Wixie?
No.
Mike Reed?
No.
Man.
Bob? I ain't never been good with names anyway.
Yeah. Well, they're all changing anyway. What about Babs? Babs Windsor. You heard of her?
Yeah.
Yeah, you know Babs. Everyone knows Babs.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
They set up the EastEnder gang here.
Okay.
You heard of them?
Yeah, of course I have.
Yeah. Everyone knows the EastEnders, yeah?
Yeah.
You ever come across that guy who did 7 years in jail for rape, Wilmot Brown?
No.
No?
No.
He raped Kathy. She was a friend of mine. With great power comes great responsibility. I am Metal Man, Man of Metal, and I shall be assisting you today on your duties. Yes. None shall escape us. Try and park. Feel our power. Are you parking? Right. Let's enforce him now. Remove his engine. Remove his engine. We must respect the double yellow code! Remove his engine! I am Metal Man, Man of Metal, here to help! You know the Chapman brothers at all? They make sort of weird statues of children and phalluses. It's a very odd mix of not art at all. And that came from one of them borrowed one of my cameras at college, and I'd taken a picture of some friends of mine's children in France, and I hadn't wound on the camera. So the next photo they took was superimposed, you know, and suddenly, you know, I'd given them the idea really on the plate. So off they went, another multi-millionaire Brit artist, and I'm left on the scrap heap. Doing charcoal drawings of idiot tourists in Trafalgar Square. It's not what I train for, but, you know, I'm prepared to work.
You spend all day waiting for trains, can you?
Pardon?
You spend all day waiting for trains.
Oh, I know. I think this one's late as well.
I'm sick of it.
What have you got nerves? Is it something exciting?
I've just come back from Venezuela, so I'm off to the zoo in Regent's Park to their reptile house. Well, it's just got something that I think they haven't got, so collection of various stuff, so I'm going to go and check with them and see if it's something they've got in their collection, and if it is, then they can have it, basically, so
wonderful.
I brought it back.
And have you got it kept all warm? Does it need to be warm, or is it all right?
It's all right, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Alive, anyway. It's still alive.
It is alive, yeah. Do you want to see it? Yeah. Yes. Hello! I'm Thomas! What's your name?
Oh, it's alive, it's alright.
I like your sandwich.
Very nice, I'm afraid you can't have it.
Oh, I like you, you're a lady. Do you want to ask her out for a drink? No, I'm alright, thank you. Go on, I bet she wants a drink. Do you want a drink? No, she doesn't. Alright, back in the box. Whiles away the time on the train, doesn't it? My wife's left me, so.
So this is a good substitute, isn't it?
I'm so ashamed. I'm sorry.
Hello. Can I tell you a little something about a charity event we're doing tonight, if you're around?
Not around.
Oh, well, can I give you a small leaflet you could hand over to someone, or just give them a thing? We're burning Carla Lane in a wicker man for charity tonight. Do you know Carla Lane?
Yeah, absolutely.
Who's the writer and stuff.
Sure, yeah.
So, which should be quite fun. Can I give you a little leaflet and you can hand it out? Huh?
I hope it goes well for you.
We should go well, yeah. We're having... So it's 7 o'clock, so if you just hand it out to someone,
yeah, cool.
6:30 come along, there'll be hymns and stuff before. This is obviously what we're using,
because yeah.
It's a bit of a myth that wicker men, you know, that wicker burns. So wicker men are generally made of wicker, but with a bit of straw, petrol and other combustibles.
Right.
So she should go up quite well, I think.
Oh, yeah,
we wanted to get Jade Goody from Big Brother, you know, originally.
Yeah, yeah.
And then a couple of other people like Dale Winton, but they wouldn't do it. And then Carla Lane stepped up to the plate, you know, very happy
right.
to be burnt.
Yeah,
so.
On, burn me alive.
Yeah, burn me alive, you know.
Yeah, we'll do that,
but it's good for charity though, anyway.
Yeah,
great. So as I said, 6:30 hymns and stuff, and then ignition 7 o'clock. Thank you very much. Goodbye. I'll tell you what it is, yeah? You are just a big black and white idiot, yeah? That no one likes, no one's like fond of in any way at all, and it's just, I don't understand what I'm supposed to do. Easy, easy! I used to run a scene down on Lavender Hill, quite a big time moneymaker. We used to steal little bicycles from girls, you know, like little girls?
Uh-huh.
Steal their bicycles, like Barbie bicycles, stuff like that. And we'd
That's
sell them on. Yeah?
Hell yeah.
Is there anyone doing little girls' bicycles at the moment, like stealing them and fitting them up, putting a silencer on and then selling them on?
No, you gotta change your game up here, man.
That could be something I could do, I think.
You gotta change your game up here.
Really?
You're in the United States now.
Hey-ya! Everybody was coming.
town. And Mark Quinn, you know him, of course.
Yeah.
The man who did the mould of his head in his own blood. He came round for a dinner party when I was living up in Columbia Road, and I had one of those novelty jello moulds, you know, where you can fill it, the jelly, into a shape.
Yeah.
Mine wasn't of my own head, it was of a goldfish. You can do it with ice as well, make ice cubes into that shape. But I could see, you know, it was red jelly in a goldfish mould, and you could see him thinking, I could do that with my own blood on my head, you know. There we go. Just one quick drain, and he's a multi-millionaire. He's got a big house in Kent.
Hello.
Big house in Mayfair.
Yeah.
Drives a Bentley. Drives it round and around my house, hooting, you know. Squat, more like. Yeah. I suppose it's annoying because I went to college with them. You know when you go to school and someone from school becomes successful? They always come back, don't they? Rub it in your face.
Yeah, that's right.
Unbelievable.
On the first part of the journey, I was looking at all the life. There were plants and birds. Rocks and things, there was sand and hills and rain. The first thing I met was a fly with a buzz and the sky with no clouds. The heat was hot and the ground was dry, but the air was full of sound. I've been through the desert on a horse with no name. It felt good to be out of the rain.
Hello, you here for the loft?
Yeah.
Go straight up.
Cheers, mate.
I can't.
That basically seems quite good, Nick. It's got a bit of clutch on it.
Hello.
Jesus.
I'm Michael.
Oh, is he up there?
Michael?
Yes. There's a man in my loft.
Yeah, he's just looking around, mate. Don't worry, just get the measurements and stuff and then come down. Michael?
Yes?
Do you just let him measure up, yeah?
Okay, carry on.
So do you show here somewhere?
Do I show it? I wouldn't show any of my stuff here if they asked me, you know. I mean, they haven't asked me, obviously. But they'd have to pay me a lot of money for me to show my stuff here. But I wouldn't. There's no way it'd be wrong, you know. If they offered me the right money, I would, because obviously it needs to be seen, you know. But I'm not competing with the people I went to college with, you know. It's a different thing that I do. I do, you know, as I said, charcoal drawings of tourists in Trafalgar Square. And,
yeah.
You know, it's not multi-million stuff, you know. It's a pound a go. On a good day, you can make 10, 15 pounds before Plod comes along and
moves you on,
you know. And I feel like turning around and saying, you know, would you move Salvador Dali on?
No.
No. Would you move Picasso on? No. Would you move me on?
Yes.
Yes. You would you?
No, I wouldn't. No, I wouldn't. They would.
All right, you just said you would, but okay. Okay.
Go on, we've got a bus.
Have you?
Yeah.
Oh, sorry, I don't mean to bore you. Sorry, I'm going on. I just bore people a little bit about it, but I just makes me angry, you know.
Yeah.
Anyway, nice seeing you. Yeah. You like modern art, do you?
Across an empty land, I knew the pathway like the back of my hand. I felt the earth beneath my feet, sat by the river and it made me complete. Oh, sympathy.
Good afternoon. You having a nice time? We don't get many people around here, often when it's a really sunny day, so I live down in the woods.
Really?
Yeah, I'm what I suppose you might call a hermit.
All by yourself?
Hey?
All by yourself?
Well, that's the idea. I read about it in a book. There was a gentleman lived on a column for a while and stuff, and so I thought I'd be a hermit, but I'm not very good at it.
Lonesome,
well, that's the problem, really. That's what they don't tell you, is you do get a bit lonely and, you know, you haven't got any cider or anything in the van, have you?
Sorry.
No, we haven't brought
anything. Oh, it's nice to hear people's voice, I have to say. It's like, I'm thinking about chucking in the whole thing really at some stage, but...
What made you want to do it in the first place then? If you obviously like all the...
I had relationship issues that I don't want to go into, but I was with a young lady for a certain amount of years and...
You felt you had to do something drastic and really alter your life?
So. No, she walked out on me and my two children and I had what I suppose you'd call, it's a terrible term, but a sort of shattering nervous breakdown, you know. And I read about this in a comic book I was reading in the sanatorium. It was about a Japanese gentleman lived on an island and sort of thought the war hadn't ended, you know. And I just thought that was it. And then the position came up and I applied for it and got it. And I don't know if it's me though, really. I don't know. Hello. I am the Greek ambassador to London, and I am down here in Cheltenham to visit the mayor.
Right.
So I will be requiring a big bouquet of flowers. Mm-hmm. You like dolmades?
Not at the moment.
No. Okay. Listen, I have to be very honest. I am the ambassador in London. I am down here for the day.
Yeah.
But I like the company of men. You would like to come to lunch with me, maybe?
Not really, thank you.
Okay. You do not do the Greek way?
I don't know what you mean, really.
Okay. I am not a married man.
No.
I like the company of men. Would you like to accompany me, maybe, for a small cocktail?
No, thank you.
Okay. I'm sorry to bother you, then.
That's all right.
Tiramisu salata?
No, thank you.
Okay. I'm sorry. The problem is just keeping a more varied menu, you know, because squirrel omelette every night is not exactly my idea of haute cuisine, but I've managed to make a squirrel risotto, squirrel chop, squirrel steak.
So you go to the shop sometimes, do you?
I never go, no, I can't. So I get what I can from people at picnics and do a bit of thieving down in the village and stuff when I have to, you know.
Well, that wouldn't go down too well, would it?
No, they put a mob up down in the village, down at the bottom, the Luckham or whatever it's called. And they sent a sort of village mob up after me, but they couldn't find the cave, so it was all right. But they had, you know, big burning bits of wood and crosses and all sorts of things and were trying to burn me out of the forest, but I don't know. Not like anywhere I've been, you know, because I lived in Stoke Newington before this, so it's obviously a bit of a jump. If I was to walk away, it's the night I fear, you know, the darkness,
no, I wouldn't like
the emptiness.
No. I could do it with a group, but I wouldn't do it on my own.
No, you're not allowed groups in hermit's caves. It's strictly against it. Sometimes I hear the screams, you know.
The animals?
No, it's me in the cave. It's just echoes around, you know. Anyway. Nice to meet you.
Yeah.
I'll have a wander and see what happens.
I'm Ronnie Cray.
Ronnie
Cray, nice to meet you. I'm from the Old Kent Road in London, so I'm just here for 2 weeks.
Oh, okay.
Soaking in some of your American culture. It's lovely. I'm having a great time.
Yeah,
but I always see you guys on television, so it's nice just to see you in the flesh. You know, you're always shooting people and stuff.
No, you got your guns, have you?
Yeah. What you got?
This is the Wild West, you know?
Bloody hell, you're sorted there, aren't you? The filth in London got nothing. You know, it's just got like truncheon and stuff like that.
Yeah,
that's it.
Yeah.
So. Either of you smell bacon?
I'll bet you're wondering what's under me kilt.
Are you? Maxi Priest, the king of light reggae.
Do you like it?
I'll be off now.
Hits, man!
I feel unhappy, I am so sad. I lost the best friend that I ever had.
She is my baby, I love her so. But it's too late now, I've let her. We shared the years, we shared each day. I love.